Hello everyone. Let us read out today's thought. The tongue has no bones, but it is strong enough to break a heart. So be careful with your words. Children, you have to be careful with your words. Once they are said, they can only be forgiven, not forgotten. In this world, nobody is going to remember you for what you have given them, they will only remember you for how you made them feel. So children, develop the art of having good people around you. Right? In previous video, we discussed about two types of changes, physical change and chemical change. This slide shows the difference between physical change and chemical change. In physical change, composition of the substance does not change and no new substance is formed. In chemical change, the composition of compounds change, composition changes and new compounds are formed. In physical change, physical properties such as state, color, density are changed. In chemical change, physical and chemical properties both are entirely changed. Physical change is temporary, chemical change is permanent. In physical change, original substance can be recovered by simple means or by merely reversing the process. For example, melting of an ice cube. After melting the ice cube, water is formed. But if we want again ice cubes, we can freeze water at 0 degree centigrade and we can get ice. So the original substance can be recovered by simple means. But in case of chemical change, original substance cannot be recovered by easy means or by reversing the process. Once the fruits are ripened, you cannot get the original raw fruit. Is it right? So note down the points of differences between physical change and chemical change. Today we are going to discuss man-made chemical changes. We bring about many chemical changes for our use in everyday life. Let us see some of them. We have seen the chemical change in the activity of soda lemon. Isn't right? It is a useful man-made chemical change. Combustion of fuels. Wood, coal, petrol or cooking gas are burnt for getting energy. The common substance that burns in all these fuel is carbon. During the combustion process, carbon combines with oxygen in air and the product carbon dioxide is formed. A common equation can be written for all these combustion processes as follows. Carbon plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide. Wood, coal, petrol, cooking gas, they are all burned for getting energy. And the common substance which burns in all these fuels is carbon. Carbon combines with oxygen in air and the product carbon dioxide is formed. Combustion of fuel is a useful man-made chemical change. Chemical equation, C plus O2 is equal to CO2. Combustion of fuel is a fast and irreversible chemical change. It is a fast change and the change cannot be reversed. So it is irreversible chemical change. Properties of carbon dioxide are altogether different from those of fuel and this change is an irreversible chemical change. Cleaning Shahabad tile with dilute hydrochloric acid. The main composition of Shahabad tile is mainly calcium carbonate. During its cleaning with hydrochloric acid, the upper layer of the tile reacts with hydrochloric acid and three products are formed. One of them is calcium chloride, which being soluble in water, gets washed away with water. The second product is carbon dioxide. It bubbles, mix up in air. The third product, water, mixes with water. The following equations can be written for the chemical change. The main constituent of Shahabad tile is calcium chloride, calcium carbonate. ड्यूरिंग इट्स क्लीनिंग विथ हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड द अपर लेयर ऑफ द टाइल रिएक्ट्स विथ हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड एंड थ्री प्रोडक्ट्स आर फॉर्म्ड. कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट प्लस हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड गिव्स थ्री प्रोडक्ट्स. कैल्शियम क्लोराइड. कैल्शियम क्लोराइड इज सोल्यूबल इन वाटर सो इट गेट्स वॉश्ड अवे विथ वाटर. द सेकेंड प्रोडक्ट इज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस इट मिक्सेस विथ एयर एंड थर्ड प्रोडक्ट इज वाटर. वाटर मिक्सेस विथ वाटर एंड दस इट इज वॉश्ड अवे एंड द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बबल्स मिक्सअप इन द एयर. सो वर्ड इक्वेशन इज कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट प्लस हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड गिव्स कैल्शियम क्लोराइड प्लस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड प्लस वाटर. Chemical equation of this process is CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate plus HCl hydrochloric acid gives calcium chloride CaCl2 plus carbon dioxide CO2 and water has molecular formula H2O. So children, you can write down this unbalanced chemical equation for the process. Write down CaCO3 calcium carbonate plus HCl hydrochloric acid gives calcium chloride CaCl2 plus carbon dioxide CO2 and water H2O. Clear? Softening of hard water. This is the third useful man-made chemical change. Some wells or tube wells have hard water. It is brackish to taste and does not form lather with soap. This is because hard water contains the chloride and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium in dissolved state. Children, hard water has salts like chloride and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium in dissolved state. And hard water does not form lather with soap and it is brackish to taste. And it is due to this, chloride and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium. To soften the hard water, a solution of washing soda is added to it. This results in a chemical reaction to form precipitate of insoluble carbonate salts of calcium and magnesium. As the dissolved salts of calcium and magnesium go out in the form of precipitate of carbonate salts, the water is softened. The following equation can be written for this chemical change. The word equation is written like this. Children, have you understood that hard water is due to dissolved salts of calcium chloride, calcium sulfate, magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate. So these salts are present in hard water and the hard water does not form lather with soap. In order to make the hard water soft, a solution of washing soda, that is sodium carbonate, is added. When calcium chloride plus sodium carbonate react with each other, calcium carbonate precipitate will form, and this precipitate, being soluble in water, gets washed away and sodium chloride is formed along with calcium carbonate. The word equation is calcium chloride plus sodium carbonate, that is washing soda, gives calcium carbonate plus sodium chloride. Here carbonate salts are formed and they are soluble with water and they get removed in this way and water becomes soft. The chemical equation for this is CaCl2, calcium chloride plus washing soda, that is sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, gives precipitate of calcium carbonate, CaCO3, plus sodium chloride, NaCl. You can write the word equation and chemical equation for magnesium salt. In case of calcium chloride, you can write down magnesium chloride. So the equation becomes word equation becomes, in case of calcium chloride you can use the word magnesium and you can frame the word equation and chemical equation. Let us do that. Magnesium chloride has formula MgCl2 plus sodium carbonate Na2CO3 gives magnesium carbonate MgCO3 plus NaCl sodium chloride. Softening process and recharge process, two processes are shown here. Hard water contains calcium and magnesium. Hardness of water is due to the chloride and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium in dissolved state. This is ion exchange resin which has sodium ions attached. Ion exchange resins is used here. Magnesium and calcium, these ions are exchanged and water has become softened in this process. The softening of hard water can be done by adding washing soda to hard water. Washing soda has formula sodium carbonate. When washing soda is added to hard water, it forms precipitate of calcium carbonate, which is removed by filtration and thus water is softened. We saw that composition of matter changes during a chemical change and new substances having different properties are formed. When this happens, some chemical bonds in the reactants break and new substances called products are formed by formation of new chemical bonds. Yes, are you getting the point? Children, whenever chemical change takes place, composition of matter changes. Reactants form new compounds and some chemical bonds which are present in the reactants, they break down and new substances called products are formed with formation of new chemical bonds. The number of chemical bonds formed by an atom is called at its valency. Children, do you remember the concept of valency? Valency means it's the combining capacity of an atom. The number of chemical bonds formed by one atom decides its valency. For example, in sodium chloride, sodium atom forms one ionic bond with chlorine atom. Na plus, that is sodium ion, and chloride ion Cl minus, they are held up together by an ionic bond. So, the valency of sodium and chlorine is 1 here. So, the number of bonds formed by an atom decides its valency. Now, let us study how chemical bond is formed between different elements when they form a new product in next video.